I love that song. They got a better stereo than I do. What the fuck? I bring all my shit down and I listen to it at your expense. Oh, God, I'm killing me. Boss Gags called. He wants that hat back, dude. Okay. Leo. Dude, wish I could wear a hat. Wish I didn't wear this shirt. That's actually what I meant. What the fuck's going on? I don't know. It's going to be here, Punchline, San Francisco. I was in the Punchline Walnut Creek last week. I've never felt so black. I'm not even black, but I felt like a corn-pone, collard-eating soul brother all fucking week long. That's how white these fuckers are. Fuckers! Did you get that? Let's underline that next exclamation point, parenthesized. Fuckers! Fuckers of you, fuckers of me, fuckers of all people for the fucking profit. Got it? Deal? Love ya. Okay. Now, they're great people, and I'm a liar. Okay. Tough week in Walnut Creek, okay? Okay. So I'm down there, and basically you got this whole approval of Bush thing in Walnut Creek, and I'm sitting there, and I'm reading the paper, and the paper has this thing, it's a telephone poll, okay? It says, if you approve of George Bush's handling of the economy, call this number and press 1. If you don't approve of his handling of the economy, call and press number 2. And he had a 90% approval rating. And then I looked at the bottom and it said, each call, $2.50. Well, that fucking explains it, huh? People who don't approve don't have 2 fucking 50 to make a call. Deal? Got it? Is that clear to you? You fucks good. See, if they want to make these polls fair, here's what they should do. For those of you who approve of George Bush's handling of the economy, call this number and press 1. Call us 250. If you don't approve, leave a stool and urine sample against the fucking front stoop of our building. Then I think the poll would be more fair, don't you? And also maybe show a true cross fucking section of the country, which is what we're after all, isn't it? The truth. Sorry I had to see that. I've never started the show like this. It's usually just dick joke, dick joke, dick joke. But I just can't help it tonight, folks. Tonight I feel the need to expound. So it's good to be here. And I love that thing, too. My, you know, my manager tells me, you work in San Francisco. Oh, cool. Where? Walnut Creek. Oh, well, thanks. It's like you work in New York City. Cool. Where? Trenton. Exactly the city. Not exactly the city proper. I live in New York. That's actually where I live. That's kind of strange for me, but what the fuck? New York, man. All these fucking homeless people. They call them homeless. You got them here, too. Let me tell you something real quick. Let's clear the air real quick on this. They're bums, okay? Bums, not homeless. Bums. Doesn't it feel better saying that and getting it right out in the open? You know, I know they're bums and not homeless because if you gave them a home, they'd still be drunk and peeing in their pants. The reason they don't have a home, and this is going to be a big fucking shock to you, ready? Because they're bums, okay? See, that's... You might as well call them Rolls Royceless. It doesn't fucking matter. There's a reason they don't have all this shit that is in their bum, B-U fucking M-bum, bum, capital B-U-M. The very idea they want me to just give them the hard-earned money my folks send to me every week. Fuck you, man. You fucking leech! Get a job! My dad works 8 hours a day for this money! Sometimes he's almost too busy to mail it, man. Fuck the homeless. Fuck them. Haven't heard that answer to the problem, have we? More bread kitchens, more soup. Fuck them. Woo! Problem's over. My Walnut Creek wore off on me, didn't it? Fuck them, man. I mean that. You ever talk to them, notice them? Mostly men, mostly alcoholics. You talk to them, they all tell you the same story. A woman broke their heart, they started drinking, they ended up in the streets. If we really care about these people, you ladies should go out and sleep with them. You're the ones that put them there, you're gonna have to get them out. Fuck the homeless! I mean, fuck them, really. Don't you want to feel one of those gravelly chins using your vagina like a spittoon tonight? Get a job, take you out to dinner, goddammit. I'm telling you, man, fuck them. I mean that. No one listens to me. No one listens to me, man. Actually, I feel very sorry for bums. Anyone could be a bum, man. All it takes is the right girl, the right bar, and the right friends, and you are well on your way, my friends. I happen to be 3 for 3. I had to quit drinking because I drank lethal amounts of alcohol and I lived. I want my fucking money back. Every doctor, you should be dead. Well, goddammit, where's that bartender? Come here! You let me walk out of here? I have professional goddamn recommendation. I'm supposed to be dead right now. Are you running a professional bar or what? Bill will beat the shit out of you if you weren't. No, not again. I had to quit drinking because I was pathetic. I'd get pulled over by the cops. I'd be so drunk, I'd be out dancing to their lights, thinking I'd made it to another club. Did not look good on the arrest report, trust me on that, please. You ask a state trooper to do-si-do, they tend to remember you. I don't know why that is. I think they would have more on their minds, but they don't. You know what I mean? And that's opposed to 10 years ago, man. Remember 10 years ago if you got pulled over and you're drinking and the cop came up to your car? Son, you been drinking? Yeah. Oops, sorry to bother you. Hope I didn't bring your buzz down any. Didn't know y'all were partying, didn't mean to startle you. All right. Sure I'll dance. A little more easy going 10 years ago, that's the point. Now, if you get pulled over and you've been drinking, that's the end of the fucking chase. There could be bank robberies going on around you, kidnappings, terrorist activities. Fuck it. Every cop car in the county pulls up to watch you audition for your freedom. Yeah, that's their favorite show, goddammit. They all get out with their coffee, they put you in their headlights, and you're on. Thank you. It's great to be here at the overpass. Well, it looks like we got quite a turnout here tonight. Lieutenant, how are you? Good to see you again. Apparently a season ticket holder for our weekend show. Lieutenant. They put you through this field sobriety test. I don't know if you've ever been through it. I found it very easy at first. The field sobriety test. First thing they told me is walk a straight line. Son, you want to come back? Come on, Lieutenant, we do that joke every weekend now. Damn it, you almost hit me that time. I'm coming back. And they go, touch your nose. It's the easiest test I've ever taken. I'll touch my nose and walk a straight line. Get some extra credit on this fucking thing. That's what I need. But then comes the kicker. Say the alphabet backwards. Well, you got me. I'm not drunk. I'm obviously too stupid to be driving, goddammit. Where the hell did that one come from? We just changed gears on that test, didn't we? Touch your cheek. Touch your glasses. Do calculus. Doing so good. Say the alphabet backwards. What does that have to do with sobriety, man? You know what? I think they're making this shit up as they go. You're drunk. They're bored. Fuck it. They can say anything. Touch your nose. Walk a straight line. Hell, son, do a flip. Pretty good. Pretty good. Come here and stick your dick in our exhaust pipe. To this one. Well, they are policemen. They know what they're doing. Damn, that's hot. Shut up. We're getting out of that alphabet deal. Screw it. I'm sober now. We should have done this back at the bar. Making this shit up. And they pop you anyway if they feel like it, regardless of what you do in that test. So I say, forget it. That's what I say, forget it. Touch your nose, walk a straight line. Ah, screw it, I'm drunk. I might puke if I start moving around a lot. How about this, officer? How about you carry me to the back of your car? I think I'll start my 18-hour nap right now, buddy. Ever seen vomit go through that mesh screen between the front and back seats? Oh, yeah. You're gonna rue the day you pulled me in, pal. I've been eating bar olives for 3 days now. Yes, sir, you caught me. I'm drunk. Woo! Man, you got me out of my car and into yours just in time, officer. Be out of jail tomorrow. You're gonna be smelling this shit for about 3 weeks, buddy. I hope I was worth it. I don't recommend doing this, by the way, but it was a semi-true story. Well, there are such things as cops. That's a fact. I don't know. I just don't feel that comfortable. God, I'm sorry. I hate myself, and it's becoming a recurring problem. It's cold here. I don't get it. What the fuck? California cold. Doesn't work for me. Sorry. I was in Chicago this winter, though. That's ridiculous, man. You ever spent a winter in Chicago, anybody? No. You answering for every... I saw everyone's itinerary earlier, Bill. No one here has ever been to Chicago. I've heard of it, seen it. You're the one. You're the only one. Okay, good. I was there one day in Chicago, 3 degrees, no wind chill at all. Little nippy. It's kind of neat, though, in that weather, going outdoors, watching smokers pass out because they didn't know when they were done exhaling. Cheap American fun, you know? Smokers cracking their heads open on the icy sidewalk. Blood steaming as it poured out. I laughed and laughed. I giggled. I blessed the fucking guy. I did. And I lied. It was me. Okay. I'm okay now. Here, just go. I do smoke. If this bothers anybody, I recommend you looking around the world in which we live and shutting your fucking mouth. Okay? Okay. Okay, non-smokers. Okay. Non-smokers amaze me. War in the Gulf, economy gone bust, recession, homeless, AIDS, and what bothers you? Quit smoking! Get a fucking priority list, man. Lot of things above smoking on the big worry list, okay? Lot, tons. Not even on the same fucking page. Smoking's on the back. Little asterisk, little footnotes. Oh, by the way, you know, eventually let's quit smoking. Eventually. After the homeless, the AIDS, and the fucking war. After that, maybe if you want, put out your cigarette. Dude, I need that kind of pressure, man. You will not die of AIDS. You will get a house and bet the last one on. Hey. Later tonight, I'm going to cough up a black phlegm ball streaked with blood for you people, so hope you enjoy that. I'm here to please. I'll tell you, the worst kind of non-smoker, the worst kind for me is when you're smoking, they just walk up to you. I always say, shit, you're lucky you don't smoke. A hell of a cough you got there, dude. I smoke all day and don't cough like that. That's weird. I'm smoking, you're coughing. If I drink, do you get drunk? I might want to party with you. I'll go out, drink all night, then drive your drunk ass home. My little party sponge. Come soak up after me. That's kind of cruel, going up to a smoker and coughing at him anyway. You know what I mean? Shit, you go up to crippled people dancing too, you fuck. Hey, Mr. Wheelchair, what's your problem? Oh, you smoked it? Fucking sadist. People say, well, Bill, you know, if you want to smoke and you want to kill yourself, that's fine. But you know what? That secondary smoke can hurt us. Yeah, I know. I'm taking you with me, you fine. Totally sober, totally conscious. I'm making a decision to kill you. Deal with it? Sleep tight. I hope we have adjoining fucking hospital beds. How does that make you feel?
Bill, why did you have to smoke? All I ever did was jog. I only ate tofu.
You're such a prick, man. You're such a whining little prick.
Well, that's why I'm killing you.
Why does he want to hurt him?
Cause you're there. I know it's a nasty habit, but you ready for this? I'm addicted. I've tried to quit. I tried cold turkey. That's really hard. I'm going to try gradually, I think. That's the way to quit. What I'm going to do is I'm going to lose one lung. And a little while later, I'm going to lose the other one. And that's it. I feel better having a plan. You know what I mean? It's like confidence that comes with responsibility. I smoke way too much, too, man. I don't know what a heavy smoker is, but I go through about 2 lighters a day now. My thumb hurts just lighting these fucking things. I mean, you know, when you pull a thumb muscle lighting a cigarette, you've crossed the line. I don't know what the line is, but I've crossed it. I look back, I wave that. No. The only good thing about smoking now is every cigarette pack has a different Surgeon General's warning. That's kind of neat. Might say warning, smoking may cause fetal injury or premature birth. Fuck it. Found my brand. Just don't get the ones that say lung cancer, you know. Shop around. Yeah, give me a carton of low birth weight. I think I can live with low birth weight. I'm prepared to meet the low birth weight challenge. But see, you understand something. I don't do anything else. I don't drink. Like I said, I don't drink. Now, a lot of you non-smokers are drinkers. I'm a non-drinker and a smoker. Now, to me, we're trading off vices. That seems fair to me. But not to you. No, I do, because first of all, we don't care whether you drink, but why should our lives be threatened by your nasty habit? Yeah, but you know what? I can't kill anybody in a car because I'm smoking a fucking cigarette. Okay? Okay. And I've tried. So. Turn off all the lights, rush them, they always see the glow. there's a big firefly heading this way. Shit, it's knocking over shrubs. I'm being very weird tonight, Paul. I'm very tired, right? Tired!
Yeah.
Tired of traveling, tired of doing comedy, tired of looking at you staring at me wanting to fucking fill your goddamn hearts with laughter. I'm sick of it. Had to get that off my chest. I want to laugh. Well, the war's over, huh? Yeah, bummer, man. It's nothing to watch. Don't you like the wars being over, man? Shit.
$1 billion too late.
First of all, there was never a war. A war is when two armies are fighting. Okay. Boy, Bush turned out to be a real demon, huh? We surrender! Not good enough. We run away. Too little, too late. We're having way too much fun. I mean, those guys were in hog fucking heaven over there. They had a big weapons catalog out. Oh, what's G12 do, Tommy? Well, that destroys everything but the fillings in their teeth. Helps us pay for the war effort. Well, shit, pull that one up. The disparity in casualties is what's fucking stunning to me. They had 100,000 casualties. We had 79. Let's go through those numbers again. They're a little baffling at first glance. Ready? They had 100,000 casualties. We had, ready? Drum roll. 79. Does that mean if we had sent over 80 guys, we still would have won that fucking thing? Just one guy in a ticker tape parade. Hey, I did it. Hey. Good work, Tommy. How'd you do it? I pulled up G12. It worked like a bucket charm. It's in the catalog. Fuck it. Good work. Send Bob next. He wants to fight the next one. All right, thanks. You know, and everyone got boners over all the technology and the weapons, and it was amazing to watch a missile go down the air vent. You know what I mean? But the way my mind works is, couldn't we feasibly use that same technology to shoot food at hungry people? You know what I mean? Fly over Ethiopia, and there's a guy that needs a banana. Hey, that was Tommy again. Tommy solved world hunger. Hey, everybody, I did it. G13, the smart banana, I pulled it up. It was in the catalog the whole time. The stealth cantaloupe is next. And I love the media. You know, they were just coming in their pants, man, this whole war. They were all wearing Depends. Every fucking... Because remember how it started? They were the elite Republican Guard. Never lost a battle. 10 feet tall. They don't shit. They don't breathe. Well, after 2 months of continuous bombing, and not, let's add them up, one fucking reaction from these guys, they became simply the Republican Guards. Not nearly as elite as we had imagined. Then after another month of continuous bombing and not one reaction at all, they became simply from the elite Republican Guards to the Republican Guards to the Republicans made this shit up about there being guards out there. We hope you've enjoyed the war. There was nobody there. Oh, they were the fourth largest army. Yeah, well, guess what? After the first three, there's a real big fucking drop-off. Okay, the fifth largest army is the Hare Krishnas, all right? Big fucking drop-off behind USA, USSR, and China. Big drop-off. Woo! an army to be seen.
The world's fourth ideally.
One guy, Tommy, just nailing him off. You know, and their big weapon, the Skid. I don't know if any of y'all have any stock in the Skid Missile Corporation, but now we have to time to sell. I looked at the footage. I saw the wreckage of the Skid. I didn't get what the fuck the thing was for. You know what I mean? It's like launching a station wagon at people, man. Some Buick flying through the air, some Iraqi and flying it. Allah! Oh, here come one of them Scud Buicks. Watch out, Tommy, watch out. Oh, in the ocean. Those things are so hard to steer.
A la bloop, a la bloop.
A la bloop, wiper.
A la, a la.
The Buick's good. I just don't understand people's bloodlust. I'll be honest with you, I don't feel it myself. Maybe it's the shirt. But, I was over in England. Has anyone here ever been to England? Can back me up on something? England, anybody?
Yeah, we're there.
Back me up on this. True or false, in England, no one has handguns, not even the cops. True or false? True. Now, in England last year, they had, ready? Drum roll. 14 deaths by handguns. 14. Okay, now. United States, and I think you know how we feel about handguns. I'm getting a stiffy. Just thinking about them. Getting a little stiffy, a little throbbing. Just thinking about those cold, hard barrels. I'm getting hard. We had 27,000 deaths from handguns. Let's go through those numbers again. They're a little baffling at first glance. England, no handguns, 14 deaths. United States, where everyone has a handgun, 27,000 deaths. But there's no connection. That you would be a fool and a communist to make one. Admittedly, in England last year, they had 27,000 deaths per soccer game. I'm not saying every system is flawless. I'm saying while in England, don't go to a fucking soccer game. That's what I'm saying. Odds are you're coming home with a t-shirt. But isn't that weird? They don't have guns, and yet they still have crime. I don't get. You know, they have a high crime rate in England. No guns. What does that do? You know, guy goes into a bank. Give me all your money. Oh, I got a fuckabo. Shit, Ian, that's a Spalding. He's serious. Hand over the pounds. Fucking God, it's not a pregnant guy. He's got a soccer ball, you fucking wanker. Look at him. Pregnant man, you fucking idiot. He's got a soccer ball. It's a hostage situation. Luckily, we send in an undercover cop with a wiffle ball in his sock. Don't fuck with English finest. Never forget that mass murderer went up in the fucking tower and threw soccer balls on people all day long. He had a tumor the size of a soccer ball in his fucking head. When are we going to outlaw soccer balls? You can go into any fucking pawn shop and get a soccer ball. I mean, on the fucking streets. Kids bringing soccer balls to fight school. Hate it. Are we not civilized? My soccer ball sketch. I just like doing English characters. Right, me. And I need to laugh too. You know what I mean, though? I don't get people's bloodlust. I don't get it. I was down in town called Fife, Alabama, not long ago. This gives you an idea where my career is at, by the way. London, England.
Fife, Alabama.
Thank you. Consistency is the key word. Anyway, I'm down there in this town called Fife, Alabama. They want me to host their annual Ricketts telethon. All right, whatever. It's an nice to be able to give something back. You know what I mean? Like vitamins. But anyway, I don't know if anyone read this or not, but last year in Fife, Alabama, they had all these UFO sightings. Does anyone remember this at all? And the whole town saw them, the police chief, the mayor. You remember this? And I was down there, and I asked people what it was like. And first of all, I got to tell you this. I'm getting real annoyed about UFOs. Crossing galaxies, universes, coming back or forth through time to visit us and going to places like Fife fucking Alabama. You know what I mean? Maybe these are not super intelligent beings. Maybe they're hillbilly aliens. Don't y'all want to land in New York, L.A., San Francisco? Nah, we just had a long trip. We're going to kick back and whittle a little bit. My God, they're idiots. Last thing I want to see is a saucer up on blocks in front of some trailer, you know? Some bumper sticker. They'll get my ray gun when they pry my dead, cold, 18-fingered hand off of it. My God, they're rednecks. Some intergalactic Jode family flying through space. But anyway, I asked people what it was like, and this guy down there goes, oh, it was incredible. People came from miles around to look at them. A lot of people came armed. Bringing shotguns to UFO sightings, man. Kind of brings whole new meaning to that phrase, you ain't from around here, are you, boy? Yep, they're little green people. We call them boogers. Why are you bringing shotguns to UFO sightings? Doesn't our xenophobia ever end? You know what I mean? Let it go. Are you afraid these aliens are coming to take your jobs? We have come to work at the Sonic Burger. We do not need roller skates. We have jetpacks to deliver our fries. They're here to take our jobs, Tommy. Sonic Burgers. But anyway, I asked that guy, I said, why did you bring shotguns to UFO sightings? He said, well, we don't want to be abducted. I'm thinking, yeah, leave all this. With 101 Dalmatians coming in the theater next month. First run. But I said, what do you mean abducted? He said, well, what they do is they abduct people and they perform scientific and medical experiments on them. Maybe you'll be lucky and it's some type of sterility dentistry program they got going. They come down here, castrate you, straighten your teeth, and split. Sort of a clean up the universe pact. It just bugs me, you know what I mean? If you ever ask yourself, if UFOs exist, how come we don't see them more often? Poaching. There's some trailer in Alabama with a deer head, a badger head, and a little green head with a real surprised look on its face. Yep, he was saying something about universal peace when I got him, Tommy. They're kind of hard to hit. They're so small and green. What you do is you aim at the glowing area around their heart. And I was over in England. You know about this in England? Those circles that show up? You knew about it before I told you. Cool. Yes, I do, sir. Yes, true. Correct. Fact.
Where are the dick jokes, honey? He promised dick jokes. Their dick jokes are on their way, ladies and gentlemen. Please relax.
Okay, look, here's the deal. I editorialized for 40 minutes. The last 10 minutes, we put on our shoes, jump out of the plane, and float down to Dick Joke Island together, all right? People are going, he's not doing any dick jokes. Doesn't he know he's in America? Doesn't he know about our puritanical self-hatred of our own bodies and its desires, and the only way we can find relief is through the medium of penis material? Yes. I'm totally aware of where I am, all right?
Trust me. Walnut feet.
Anyways, anyone know about this in England? These circles that show up in the middle of fields overnight? They think it's aliens landing in these fields. And I was over there and I asked people what it was like. And this guy said, oh, it was incredible. People came from miles around. A lot of them brought soccer balls.
It never fucking ends. Humanity's stupid and you never fucking ends. I don't get it.
Are there any questions so far? Good to be here. Like I say, I don't drink. I don't do drugs anymore. I used to do drugs. I quit doing drugs, too. What? But I smoke. You're very fucking observant of you. Let me say I don't do drugs that change my perceptions. How about that, Missy? Okay, are we going to split hairs together? I'll split your hairs. I don't do drugs that change my perception. How about love? Great. Though I used to. And I'll tell you something about drugs. I have nothing against drugs at all. Kind of weird, huh? Used to take drugs, quit taking drugs, and yet has nothing against drugs. Never heard that. Let's hear more. All right. I'll tell you something else I know is not a very popular idea, but it's the truth. Not only did I used to take drugs, I had a real good time doing drugs. Sorry. Never murdered anybody, never robbed anybody, never raped anybody, never beat anybody, never lost a house, a job, or a wife, laughed my ass off, and went about my day. Sorry. Now, where's my commercial? Shit, I'll be the guy holding that skillet in that commercial. That ain't a brain, that's breakfast. Let's eat. What have we been up 5 days now? I'm starving! I find that commercial really insulting to my intelligence. You know the one, here's your brain on drugs. Because I've seen a lot of weird shit on drugs, a lot of weird shit. Never, ever, ever have I looked at an egg and thought it was a brain. Not once. I have seen UFOs split the sky like a sheet before, but I've never, ever, ever looked at an egg and thought it was a fucking brain. Seven balls of light come off of a UFO, lead me onto their ship, explain to me telepathically that we are all one and there's no such thing as death, but you know what? Never, ever, ever have I looked at an egg and thought it was fucking brain. Now, maybe I wasn't getting good shit. Okay. Possibility. I admit it. I look at that commercial. I feel cheated, you know. Hey, where's the stuff that makes eggs look like brains? I never got that. Did I quit too soon? What is that, CIA stash for me? And you seen the guy in that commercial, the guy's got a beer gut. All right, this is it. Look at it now. See that here? That's your brain. Your brain. Look at it. See that? Your brain is right here. That's it. This is your brain. All right, check it out. There's your brain. This guy's drunk doing the goddamn commercial. Here's your brain. That's an egg. That's a frying pan. That's a stove. You're an alcoholic. Dude, I'm tripping right fucking now, and that's a goddamn egg, all right? I see the UFOs around it, but that's an egg in the middle. There's a unicorn eating it, but that unicorn is eating a fucking egg. How dare you have a wino tell me not to do drugs? How dare you? And that is what's such bullshit about the war on drugs, is that all day long we see those commercials. Here's your brain, just say no. Why do you think they call it dope? And the next commercial is this bud's for you. Come on, America, let's be hypocritical bastards. Come on. It's okay to drink your drug. We meant those other drugs. Those untaxed drugs. Those are the bad ones. Don't you see that? Thank God they're taxing alcohol, man. It means we have those good roads we can get fucked up and drive on. Man, thank God they're taxing this shit, huh? We'd be doing donuts in a wheat field right now. Thank God we're on a highway. See, with tax drugs, the ambulance can get to you quicker over the road than the tax money bill. Yeah, it's well thought out. I'll tell you, man, if I were going to legalize a drug, it would not be alcohol. Sorry. There's better drugs and better drugs for you. By the way, that's a fact, and you may stop your internal dialogue.
Wait a minute, Bill. Alcohol is an acceptable form of social interaction.
Shut the fuck up. Your denial is beneath you, and thanks to the use of lots of hallucinogenic drugs, I see through you. Okay? Oh, yes, I do. And denial is my fucking strong suit.
I will guide you through denial.
I am the Moses of fucking denial. One of my wives.
I have many wives.
Not only do I think marijuana should be legalized,
brother, come here.
I think it should be mandatory. I'm a hardliner. Think about it, man. You getting traffic behind somebody? Shut up and smoke that. It's the law. Oh, sorry, I was taking life seriously. Oh, man, who's hungry? That'd be a nice world, wouldn't it? Quiet, mellow, hungry, high people everywhere. Just Domino's pizza trucks passing each other. Every single highway, parades of Domino's. Let them get stuck in traffic, all our pizzas will be free. I'm a dreamer, man. But I'm not the only one. Someday you're going to join us. And ooh, we're gonna giggle. Pot is a better drug than alcohol. Oh, by the way, fact. Fact.
Shit it.
I'll prove it to you. You're at a ball game or a concert. Someone's really violent and obnoxious and aggressive. Are they drunk or are they smoking pot?
Drunk.
Drunk. I have never seen people on pot get in a fight because it is fucking impossible. Hey, buddy. Hey, what? End of argument. Hard to hold a resentment when you can't remember it. Say you get in a car accident and you've been smoking pot. You're only going 4 miles an hour. Shit, we hit something. We got rear-ended by a Domino's truck, man. It's their fault. That means it's free. God damn it. Aren't we the luckiest bastards in the world? What? I don't know either. It's just a better world, man. That's all I'm saying. Isn't that what we all want, really, deep down, is a better world? Hot's better. Fact. And I'm not promoting the use of drugs. I'm just telling you that, you know, if you're going to have a war against drugs, have it against all drugs, including alcohol, the number one offender, which kills more people than crack, coke, and heroin combined. And cigarettes. Or shut your fucking mouth. That's what I'm talking. But cigarettes are not the same as alcohol, madam. Okay? I never. Forget it. I can't. They're not. It's not the fucking same. And I'm telling you the truth, I've had good times on drugs. Sorry, that's a fact, okay? I've also had bad times on drugs too, okay? But I've had good and bad relationships, and I'm not giving up pussy. Hi, I'm Bill, I'm a pussyholic. I like the way it smells. Love the way it tastes. You're in the right place, man. Keep coming back. We are all powerless over pussy here.
You want to know?
I have had bad times on drugs. One time, me and three friends dropped acid, drove around in my dad's car. He's got one of those talking cars. We're tripping. The car goes, the door is ajar. We pulled over and thought about that for 12 hours. How can a door be ajar? Shit, I don't know, but I see it. I see it too. Fuck. Why would they put a jar on a car? I don't know. What's that? That's an egg. Well, great, we're not that high yet. We're getting a hotel room. I'll drive in the jar of cars. That brain egg thing that fucked me up. Yeah. Ken, I'm not proud of this moment in my life, but you know what? Here's my point. Here's my point. I knew it. God damn it, I knew it. I knew if I bullshitted long enough, a point would come to me. Bill, what is it? Oh, okay. My point is, I wasn't a criminal when I did drugs. No more than you're a criminal because you're drinking a beer. People who do drugs are not criminals. They might be sick, but I don't think jail's going to heal them. Thank God they caught me. The hell was I doing ruining my life with that marijuana? Thanks to Bubba back there, my new rehabilitator. I would not come out of jail wanting to do less drugs. I would want to come out mainlining heroin in the vein under my cock, ladies and gentlemen, just so I would forget every fucking second of that goddamn time. You understand fully what I'm saying here? Jail's not going to heal anybody. Okay, 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 okay. I was almost arrested, so I know how scary it can be. I got pulled over tripping on LSD. I'm not proud of this night. It was the longest night of my fucking life. Cops were tapping on this window. We're staring at them in this mirror. How tall are you?
I'm just little bitty. Look at them.
How do they drive that big fucking car? There might be a bunch of them. What are we gonna do? Let's put them in the jar. Maybe it made perfect sense at that moment, right? Put them in the jar, poke some holes in the lid, leave them by the road. You'll never get us. Your cuffs won't even fit us. Are you kidding with that little toothpick fucking nightstick? Get out of here. Lucky we don't stomp on you. I want to keep one. Shut up! We're not keeping them. I want to put them in my habit trail, man. We're not keeping them, Tommy. We're letting them go. But see, that's our problem, and it's never changed from day one. Our continuous search for enemies outside of ourselves. Drugs, yeah, there, that's the answer. Whew, thank God we solved it. I feel better. People forget about drugs, man. You've all forgotten about them. Drugs have done good things for us. And if you don't believe they have done good things for us, do me a favor to follow up on that belief. Go home tonight, take all your albums, your tapes, and your CDs and burn them. Because you know what? The musicians who made that great music that's enhanced your lives throughout the years? Real fucking high on drugs. Shit, man, the Beatles were so high, they let Ringo sing a couple of tunes. Tell me they weren't partying. We all live in a yellow submarine. What? We all live... You know how fucking high they were when they were out there? They had to pull Ringo off the ceiling with a rake to sing that fucking song. John, get Ringo. He's up in the corner. Put him down. Wow, look at him scoop. Grab him, John. Grab him. He's got a song he wants to sing us. Something about living in a yellow tambourine or something. I fucking love it.
Uh-oh, John just went up there. Oh, shit, get your...
Oh, just bring the microphones up here. We'll sing from the roof. On behalf of me and the band, I hope we pass the audition. That's what he said after they sang on the roof. Ooh, it all makes sense. Enemies outside of ourselves. Every few years, rock and roll becomes the enemy. That always fascinates and amuses me. You know what I mean? Like this Judas Priest trial that went on last year. Remember this? These two kids committed suicide, and the parents of these two kids sued the band Judas Priest because they were big fans of the band. First of all, two kids, big fans of Judas Priest, commit suicide. Yeah. Two less gas station attendants in the world. I don't mean to sound cold or cruel here, but I don't think we lost a cancer cure with those two. Besides, most stations are self-serve now anyway. I think they saved themselves a long, troublesome job search. But you know what they're trying to prove, don't you? That there are subliminal messages on these albums telling you to kill yourself. I need help right now, goddammit. What performer wants his fucking audience dead? Help me here. I don't see the long-term benefits. What are these guys in the band thinking? I'm fucking sick of it. I am fucking sick of it. Sick of the touring. Sick of making $400,000. I fucking know it. Sick of the free drugs, the free booze, the stretch limos, the penthouse suites. The groupies blowing me dawn to fucking dusk. I'm in a rut and I want out. Yeah, we got all those concerts coming up. I know it sucks. Unless... Ian, Nigel, come in. Oh, shit, Nigel, get Ian. Ian! Wow, look at him scoot. Grab him. Ian, I've had an idea. What if we kill the fucking audience? Nigel, go get a soccer ball. Ian! We can go back to our day jobs. We can sell shoes again. Ian! We will never have 15-year-old pussy on our faces again. Ian! I've solved all of our problems. Why would a band do that? Help me, Irish. Because, Bill, Mr. Dressed in Black in the Bay fucking area. Oh, sorry. Because it's not a band, son. Mr. Cynic. Mr. Humanist. It's the devil. Oh. I stand correct. The devil. The ultimate enemy outside of ourselves. Huh? Remember a few years ago, it was if you played albums backwards, there were satanic messages. Now they're subliminal. Isn't it nice to know Satan's keeping up with all the new technological advances? Picture Satan at Radio Shack every Monday morning. What new things do you have for me today? It's my Satan impression. I only saw him once. Sorry. Walnut Creek. The mayor. I love that. Remember that? A few years ago. Only a few years ago in this country, in this day and age. We were all alive when this happened. You play rock albums backwards, there's satanic messages. Really? I think, yeah. Let me tell you something. If you're sitting around your house playing your albums backwards, you are Satan. Don't look any further. And don't go ruining my stereo to prove a fucking point. Come here. Listen. Listen. Can you hear that? It's Satan is Lord. Satan is Lord. Can you hear that? Man, it's crystal clear. It's like he's in the room or something. Oh, my God, you're Satan. Ah! Satan, destroyer of needles, ruiner of stereos. I am Satan, and I've come to destroy high-fidelity music. You will all listen to 8 tracks.
Oh, it's the evil one.
Because I got news for you. I got great news for you. Ready? Here we are, the latter part of the 20th century, the world obviously in flux, many people's beliefs being challenged on a daily basis, correct? Let me throw a bone in that soup, if I may. They say rock is the devil's music. Well, let's say that rock and roll is the devil's music, and we know it for a fact to be true. Boy, at least he fucking jams. Okay, did you hear that correctly? If it's a choice between eternal hell and good tunes or eternal heaven and new kids on the fucking block, I'm gonna be surfing on the lake of fire rocking out. High-fiving Satan every time I pass him.
Are you enjoying the show? Your black is so trendy down here, young man. Oh, please, by all means, smoke.
You know, if you play New Kids on the Block albums backwards, they sound better. None of this is fiction. The New Kids. I'll never understand the appeal of the New Kids on the Block, ever. I'm not proud of that. I just don't get it. You can sit with me from now to the end of time, buy me a big pot of coffee, try to explain to me the appeal of the New Kids, and I won't get it. Because no matter what you said, to explain the appeal of the New Kids, all I would say would be a very repetitive, but they suck. You know what I mean? I don't know what you would say to get over that big, tall, but they suck wall that I have built. Bill, they're young, they dance well, the kids like them, but they suck. Get away from my fucking wall. Someone actually asked me once, who's your favorite Nick kid? The first one that fucking dies, okay? That's the one. That's the poster that's going up in my room. And I hope it's Donnie, that scruffy little rebel. I hope Donnie gets that one chin hair he's been working on for 3 fucking years stuck in the front wheel of his scooter and it pulls his head off like a champagne cork coming out. He's in the middle of the highway like a plasma sprinkler. And I hope his mom's there. Watch it happen. Yeah, his mom. His mom. There's a product of your love, Miss Donnie. You didn't give birth to him. You shat him. Admit it. Congratulations, Miss Donnie. It's a turd. Now wipe your ass and get out of our house. Because they suck. See, when I was a kid, I didn't like suck music. I like good music. Same music I like today. Because I just have the fucking knack. I don't have any fucking musical skeletons in my closet, okay? Come over, look at my albums. Same albums I had when I was fucking 12, 10, 11, 9, fucking 8. Really, Carpenter? Any Partridge Family? No! Monkey? No! Diane Marie? No! Lou Reed, that's what I had when I was 5. Lou fucking Reed when I was 5! 5! My dad took me to his concert, man. He shot me up! Said something about you, man. Maybe it's the black diapers. Come here, kid.
Jimmy.
Oh, man. Drugs, rock and roll. What does that leave? Dick jokes. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you enjoyed the ride. We are now at Dick Joke Island. I hope my little 45 minutes editorializing didn't trouble you too much, but you will soon forget after the plethora of penis material you're about to see. From the crown to the balls, we'll discuss it all, ladies and gentlemen. No facet of the penis will go unremarked upon. I am to please my American audiences.
Talk about our weenies, Bill. Talk about our weenies. Make us weenie-free people.
Are y'all tired? Y'all seem more tired tonight than last night's crowd. Y'all all right?
Yeah.
A lot of y'all are staring at me like I've sprouted another head or something. Jesse Helms calls it.
Pornography.
I don't think you should be against something till you can pronounce it.
New rule?
What is pornography? I don't know what it is. Supreme Court says pornography is any act that has no artistic merit and causes sexual thoughts. That's their definition. No artistic merit causes sexual thoughts.
Sounds like every commercial on television.
You know, when I see those two twins on that Double Man commercial, I'm almost embarrassed to tell you. I'm not thinking about gum.
Double your pleasure.
Yeah, honey, where's the Wrigley's? I feel like chewing something. Doesn't every commercial blatantly use sex to sell the product? Here's the commercial they'd like to do if they could. I guarantee you, we might see it one day yet. Here is the ultimate television commercial they want to do for us. Okay? Here's the woman's face, beautiful. Camera pulls back, naked breast. Camera pulls back, she's totally naked. Legs apart, two fingers right here. And it just says, drink Coke. I don't know the connection. But I'm drinking some fucking Coke this week. Snickers. Dr. Pepper. No, I don't know the connection. Yes, I'm buying these products. My teeth are rotting out of my head. I'm glued to the television.
More Snickers, more Coke. We must keep these companies afloat.
But here's the question no one asked in the entire pornography debate, and I'll ask it tonight since I'm wearing all black and I walk fucking alone. I'll go ahead and just keep going, all right? No one asked this question, and no one has, and also I'll ask it. This whole thing about causes sexual thoughts. Yeah, so, and what? When did sex become a bad thing? Did I miss a meeting? Bill, we had a big vote. Pussy's out. You're asleep. Wake me for that vote. I might be a swing vote. Playboy pornography causes sexual thoughts. Penthouse pornography causes sexual thoughts. You know what causes sexual thoughts? I'm going to clear the air for you tonight. The debate's over as of now. I'm tired of it. It's beneath us. There are real issues that aren't being discussed. Ready? Here's what causes sexual thoughts, okay? Having a dick, okay? Case fucking closed. Case closed. End of fucking story. Story's over. The end. I can speak for every guy here tonight. You know what? Think I will. In the course of our fucking day, anything can cause a sexual thought, all right? You can be on a train, a bus, a trolley car. It's rocking kind of nice. Your pants are a little tight. Oh, my God, I got a Woody. I got a Woody on a bus. What are we going to do, ban public transportation? Before Playboy, before Penthouse, before pornographic movies ever existed, people still had sexual thoughts, okay? How do you know that, Bill? Well, we're here, aren't we? Somebody's been fucking. And you live with that. You follow your family tree back at every branch. fucking... Okay. What caused it way back then? Well, maybe the wagon train ride out west. Ding, 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 ding. I don't know what she has under that gingham skirt, but when we start for water, we're fucking, honey. I got a Woody on the trail. I got a Woody on the trail. You see, they're getting the cart before the horse on this pornography issue. Playboy did not create boners. There's a boner market already fucking out there and ain't going away, okay? Another benefit of not drinking. My boner is here to stay. I am Man of Steel. I find it ironic. People that are against things that cause sexual thoughts are generally fundamentalist Christians who also believe you should be fruitful and multiply. Seems like they would support things that cause sexual thoughts. Perhaps even a centerfold in the Bible. Miss Deuteronomy. Turnoffs, floods, locusts, and smokers. Perennial fucking smoker turnoff. I did that joke in Fife, Alabama, and these three rednecks met me after that show. Hey, buddy, come here. Hey, Mr. Comedian, come here. Yeah, I love that move. Come here. Not a physics major. Okay. Call me Sherlock. Mr. Funny Man, come here. Hey, buddy, we're Christians. We don't like what you said. I said, then forgive me. Later, when I was hanging from the tree, hanging next to this little green fella.
What are you in for? Oh, I came down to work at the Sonic Burger. I wanted to see 101 Dalmatians, and I don't know, they strung me up. The bastards are killing aliens. Leave the fucking aliens alone. I love that little alien. They're so cute.
Now, I know, you know, women, as a general rule, do not like pornography. I know my girlfriend hates it when I bring home one of those films, because sometimes they get mixed up in the boxes at the video store. For a dollar extra. But anyway, it's always a shocking night of entertainment in our house. Hey, this isn't Bambi. Shut up, her name is Bambi. Pay attention, maybe you'll learn something, honey. See, that's not hurting her. Glad I'm not the only guy who's tried that. Good. No, it might hurt. Well, let me go get Anal Intruders Volume 1 through 12, and we'll take notes. Now you're getting fucking pompous on me? I didn't see y'all mount your high horses. Sorry.
We will mount our high horse. You will be our custer.
Hi-ya-ya-ya. These are just... But her attitude, I'll be watching one of those films and she'll come in, she'll go, that woman is not enjoying that. She is not enjoying doing that. I'm going, well, honey, she's got a pretty big grin on her face. And we know she's not a good actress. I think she's digging it. But her attitude is that those movies are degrading to women. And I say, look at the guys. Are they exalted? I could make a face like that if a car ran over my foot. She looks great. He looks like a doofus. If I had my way, there wouldn't be any men in pornographic films.
Hey.
That's right. The only thing more beautiful than a woman is two of them. Do I seem shallow? Bill, there's great emotional depth in you.
Maybe it's the jacket. Maybe it's the jacket.
I'm in triple-dipple hell right now. I have a question I'd like to ask you. It's very crude, I warn you up front, but there is a reason I'm asking. It's not done gratuitously. I'll do that stuff in a minute. Here's my question. Are there actually women in the world who do not like to get blowjobs? No, she answers over here. No, there are not. Since I quit smoking cigarettes, no, we've got to do something. Hey, man, thanks. Could have been an assassin. Where the fuck were you guys? Damn it, where's my backup? The old he needs water trick. That's what fucking Ruby did with Oswald. Well, Jack, what are you doing down here? He looks thirsty. Oh, Jack's giving him some water. Historical assassination joke. Historical and accurate. Are there actually women like that? Why do I ask that good question? The reason I ask, I was with this woman one time. She goes down for like 3 seconds and starts coming back up. And I'm going, no. Unless you're getting up to put ice in your mouth. Anyway, without getting graphic, she actually said to me, you've had enough. What? I said, you will know when I've had enough. Pretty definite ending to this. Fairly cut and dry here, yes. Not a lot of gray area involved in a blowjob. Subjectivity does not come into play. You're blown or you're not. And I wasn't. It blew my mind. That's about all it blew. So I've been inquiring why you ladies don't like to suck your guys' dicks. I don't understand why you wouldn't want to do that all the time unless rounded off to ooh constantly. Seriously, I don't get it. Why don't you like to do that? Actually, I had a woman one night go, yeah, you ever try it? Said, yeah. Almost broke my back. It's that one vertebrae, I swear to God. I think that vertebrae is going to be the thing to go in our next evolutionary step. Not going to be the opening of the mind or the heart. That vertebrae is going to disappear. Just a theory of mine. And a fervent prayer. But I asked that, and you guys are going, honey, I don't know what he's talking about. Yeah, well, guys, guess what? You know what the fuck I'm talking about. Guys, if you could blow yourselves, ladies, you'd be in this room alone right now, watching an empty stage. Where'd all the guys go? He said something about getting eyes. They just scuttled off. They look happy. But anyway, I asked that woman who said that, you ever try it? I said, let me ask you a question. Why don't you like to suck your guy's dick, if that's not too personal? You never know when you're crossing the line. And the guy she was with goes, yeah. It's good to have an ally, you know? And she said, because it's disgusting. Disgusting? That's a tad harsh. You know what? It's also a double standard, because I have never heard you ladies say it's disgusting when we're down between your legs gnawing away. Oh, this is so gross. I'm going to throw up. Oh, don't put your finger in my head. Oh, that's real. I've never heard that. Guys, you ever heard that before? Yeah, me either. Then again, maybe I can't hear it because your thighs are clamped. God, I hope she's enjoying this. Getting that headache down here. I feel like drinking a Coke, too. What the hell's that all about? An intense desire for a soda pop.
commercials work, goddammit!
Well, folks, you've been a wonderful crowd. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm feeling weird, and that's why I'm acting weird. I don't usually act this weird. I don't, man. Come on, man. Let me take the mask off. Oh, Bill, shut up. Do your fucking act and leave. All right, good. We don't care about you, Bill. You think we care about you? Oh, man. I'm available for children's parties, by the way. Some of y'all might have a youngin' coming of age, not want to go the traditional clown balloon animal route this year. You want to look me up, Beelzebozo. Clown from hell. Hey, kids, who wants to learn how to smoke today?
It's Beelzebozo!
Who's ever seen a skin flick here? Check this out. Make some balloon incubus for you kids to play with. There's a succubus for the little birthday girl. That's a demon spirit that fucks you in your sleep. Succubus. Learn something with Beelzebozo around, don't you, kids?
Mommy, make him go away!
Who wants to learn how to play craps? Go get your mommy's cookie money. Come here! Now if that means I win. No, if that means I win. That means I win, too.
Mommy, make him go away!
It's Beelzebozo time! Where's your cat? I want to show you how to do a sacrifice. Come here! It's a fantasy, I know. Being Beelzebozo. Oh, you realize I'm going to hell for this show, I hope. That's what someone told me, this woman in Alabama. She's going, you're going to hell, boy! Fuck, I'm already in Alabama, lady, whatever, you know. Say something that might scare me, like my return ticket is canceled. Here's my final point, and I'll leave. Yeah, thank you. Here's my final point, though. About drugs, about alcohol, about pornography. What business is it of yours what I do with me? As long as I don't hurt anyone else. No, nobody's business, really, is it? But what do they say in response to that? But we have to protect the children. Let me tell you something. Children are smarter than any of us. You know how I know that? I don't know one child with a full-time job. Children. That's how fucking smart they are. Right out of the womb, they're like whips, these kids. It's only after we get a hold of them. Where did this veneration of children come from all of a sudden? So it's very new. Oh, childbirth is such a miracle. It's such a miracle. No, it isn't. No more a miracle than eating food and a turd coming out of your ass. You know what a miracle is? A miracle is raising a kid who doesn't talk at a fucking movie theater. Now we're in the miraculous domain. A miracle is raising a kid who doesn't run into my crotch at the supermarket because they have no peripheral vision. Where is that little miracle? Come here. Come here, you. It's Beelzebozo time. It's Beelzebozo time. It's not a miracle if every 9 months any yin-yang in the world can drop a litter of these mewling cabbages on the fucking planet. And in case you haven't read the single mom statistics lately, miracles spreading like fucking wildfire. It's unstoppable. Boom, 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 boom. Filling up trailers all over America. Boom, boom, boom. Like sardine cans filled with little fishy fucking miracles. Boom, boom. Be a miracle if I got laid after this set. That'd be the fucking miracle. You guys have been great. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you very much.